Hey everyone, Ariel Adams here with aBlogtoWatch. Please subscribe to our videos on YouTube and like this video if you find it useful. Don't forget to hit the bell to be notified of our upcoming videos. This is a review of the Wempe Iron Walker Automatic Chronograph, and it's a beautiful timepiece. Wempe is a German watch retailer. They have one location in the United States in New York City at this point, a lot more locations in Germany. And for the last several years, they have been producing their own watches in addition to selling watches by other brands such as Rolex and Patek Philippe. So they're an authorized dealer of many popular watch brands as well as a manufacturer themselves. They produce in Glashütte, where basically most all of the high-end German watches come from, including things like A. Lange & Söhne, Glashütte Original, and many more. So they're up there in Glashütte. And actually, Wempe owns the observatory, I believe, and the observatory is where all the German-made chronometer watches are tested. And so a German chronometer is a little bit different than a Swiss chronometer. There's a company called COSC in Switzerland, Geneva, which certifies chronometers in Switzerland and Germany. It's the observatory in Glashütte, which certifies them. It's a little bit more of a stringent process. And this I'm pointing that because this watch is indeed a German chronometer. The Iron Walker comes in a few different versions. There's the automatic chronograph. There's a three-hand automatic. There is a three-hand automatic diver, and there's also a three-hand quartz version. The chronograph is probably the most impressive in terms of detailing, things like that, because it has the most going on. They all share this great steel case. This one happens to be 42 millimeters wide with an integrated bracelet. Polishing is excellent and a lot of value for the price point. Inside the watch is a Swiss Made ETA Valjoux 7753 automatic chronograph movement. And this is a chronograph movement which has a more symmetrical layout. So the 7750 would be more like this, and the 7753 is more like this. One of the little quirks of the 7753 is that there is a date corrector pusher. It's a little inset pusher right here. And the watch does come with a little tool, or you could use something they usually call it a stylus. I recommend something which isn't metal, so you usually should use the tool supplied or like a toothpick. Toothpicks are one of the only things I can think of that allow you to push this. And this is if you need to manually adjust the date, and that's just a little quirk there. I love the chronograph pushers there. These sort of rectangular shaped angled chronograph pushers play really well with a lot of the polished surfaces, and you also have a nice action there for the chronograph. Let's reset that one. It's always fun to play with the chronograph. I know some people have chronograph watches and they just let the chronograph running perpetually. I don't necessarily know why. They just have fun with it that way. Jean-Claude Biver, for example, he was someone that famously would wear chronographs just running all the time, not necessarily running or timing anything. So let's put the watch on. The chronograph version of the Iron Walker comes in two dial colors at the debut, this beautiful metallic blue, as well as a version with a black dial and silver, kind of whitish subdials that gives it a nice sort of high contrast panda, reverse panda, whatever look to it. This one's going to be a little bit more dressy, a little bit more elegant, and the one with the high contrasting subdials is going to be a bit on the sportier side. The clasp is relatively thin, which is nice, so you don't have too much of a bulk underneath here. The whole point of this watch was to be something that fit nicely within the integrated bracelet category. So steel watches with a very impressive level of finishing, so almost a jewelry style finishing. You can actually see how high that bezel is. So the bezel is sloped, polished, and that height with that very strong polished line around there is a big part of the personality. People have looked at the Iron Walker chronograph and said, that looks a little bit like this watch, or that looks a little bit like that watch. It is true that Wempe is trying to produce something within an existing category. And in order to look familiar within that category, there's certain types of iconic looks. For example, this design of the integrated lugs, it just sort of ends and kind of flows into the bracelet, and sort of the hour markers on there. These are familiar looks, but they are blended in a way, I'll call them curated in a way, which is original. So I think that when you wear this watch, it does have a familiarity to it, but you don't actually think it's anything else. It is the Wempe Iron Walker, and it will always be just the Iron Walker. And that's good because there's that level of distinctiveness. So if you can pick it out of a crowd. One of the reasons that people are so excited about this watch, in addition to the availability that you can buy it, as well as the great design and the great quality and the great specs, is the price. This is the most expensive of the Iron Walker watches right now. They're all in steel, of course, and the retail price is $4,250. The non-chronograph automatics are less, and the quartz ones even less. So very, very strong price point coming in. You can see the full review of the Wempe Iron Walker Automatic Chronograph on aBlogtoWatch. Thanks.